Hello, this is Sarah, also known as Cosmignon. It's been a little bit since I uploaded a speed paint because you know how it goes. My next intention was to record the speaking audio for this speed paint that you're watching right now of my character Lillian from Dice Funk. But then I was like held up on what I wanted to talk about. What I wanted to say, because this would be my first like long form voiceover. If you look at my shorts, you'll see a couple of commissions that I did earlier in the year that I did voiceovers for really quickly, and this is the first one that would be like longer than a minute. So I was like, okay, what do I talk about? What do I put out there for the world for these honestly surprising number of subscribers I have? I know you're out there. I see the numbers. And so I just got held up on it, and it, like, hung up on it for so long that I ended up not recording it for, like, 4 months of putting off this one, and therefore not putting out speed paints for any of the other ones, except for April, which was the Homestuck one. I think that's the last one that I posted. But, you know, I have finally, like, bit the bullet and gone, okay, I'll record something. So, what do I want to talk about? Well, first of all, my name is Sarah, as I said. I'm Cosmignon. You might know me from Tumblr, Twitter, Instagram. Like, a lot of you probably know me from Dice Funk, specifically, because I've been a character on there for 1.5 seasons now. My first character, Gladys, was from season 9, and I joined about halfway through because the DM, Austin, decided he wanted to do, like, a mini-series, like, in between, like, the main campaign. So he enlisted me, as well as Dan and Skitch. I had never been on the show before. The other two had, at least in, like, a one-shot capacity. But before that, I was a fan artist who was a big fan of the show because I've been listening to Dice Funk since 2016, which is 8 years now. That's crazy. So I really wanted to make a good first impression, and I think I did. I think a lot of people like Gladys. But now, with season 11 currently releasing episodes right now, and you can listen to them Sundays on the Dice Funk channel, which you can just look up Dice Funk on YouTube and be able to find it really easily. The season's called Banyan. The character that I'm playing is a dryad bard called Lillian Sparage. And Lillian is an actor by trade. Lillian's bardic college is technically the College of Spirits because it felt fitting to have a character who would be doing the campaign about, like, entering people's mind palaces and, like, judging, like, their mortal souls and seeing if they could come back from the dead, to have a character who had, like, a spirits, like, influenced subclass. But I renamed a couple of the flavor parts of the subclass to be more relevant to a bard. So technically, Lillian is, like, a bard of drama. Like, Lillian is a floral, dramatic actor. And as you can see on the screen right now, I have a lot of flowers that I'm specifically pulling from, and that's because Lillian has a table called Tales from Beyond as part of Fair Subclass. That means that if I use a bardic inspiration dice, like I use one of my bardic inspiration instead of inspiring someone else, like I can use it to summon one of these like 12 magical abilities that either I or somebody else could use. And I have a list of like the ones that I currently have access to, which is Clever Animal, Renowned Duelist, Beloved Friends, Runaway, Avenger, Traveler, Beguiler, and Phantom, which are reflected in the flowers, respectively, Aster, Gladiolus, Forget-Me-Not, Tumbleweed, Birdsfoot Trefoil, Dandelion, Venus Flytrap, and Spiderfly. And then there are a couple of other ones that are higher up on the list that I technically don't have access to, but I have definitely looked at them because it's like a 1d12 list. The Brute, the Dragon, the Angel, and the Mind, which I renamed to be the Rose, the Dragon's Breath Pepper, the Devil's Trumpet, and Fungi. I think that renaming them to be flowers is a really fun way to like give the subclass my own like flavor to like kind of make it more appealing to me specifically. And that also meant that, as you can see here, I drew all of them to kind of frame the curtain that is the stage that Lillian performs on. I think in terms of the actual character design for Lillian, a lot of the inspirations that I took were from other, like, bardic characters that I really like. The most important one is going to be the bard from Wandersong, actually, who is also a non-binary character. I think the bard takes any pronouns, but is usually referred to as they in the game itself, and meanwhile Lillian uses they-them pronouns and also fey-fair, which is a set of neo-pronouns that follow, like, the convention of fey is an actor that is fair stage that fey are standing on. And I think that it's fun to have a character who is inspired by someone like the bard specifically, because I think really optimistic, naive about the world characters are fun to explore, and I think that a lot of the things that I've explored so far on Dice Funk with Lillian have been interesting. They've been very challenging to me as, like, a person to actually get a character through, like, experiencing these kinds of, like, challenges to, like, a naive worldview, and I like to think that I've been doing a pretty good job at it. The thing about playing a D&D character on the air for people to listen to is that I'm very aware of the fact that there is an arc that I'm trying to get to at the end. I can't have the benefit of, like, being an actor on stage with a script. This is all improv. I have an idea of the direction Lillian's character could go down as we near, like, the final, like, recordings that Lillian is going through. Our recording schedule is about a couple months ahead of the actual production, so if you want to catch up to Dice Funk right now, you'll be in a really good spot to listen to, like, the most recent arc that features Lillian's, like, team, like, going through, like, someone else's mind and, like, experiencing, like, the horrors. We love to experience the horrors. Then you could get invested in that, and, like, by the time that this video comes out, like, you'll still have so much story left to experience that, honestly, I think has been really fun and fulfilling. I think that this is a really cool season of Dice Funk to get started with if you're interested in it. You could also listen to older seasons, but those don't have me in them. Hopefully you like hearing a little bit about my process on these videos. I can't actually promise that these will happen frequently because, like I said, I could get hung up on it. So they might go back to being just, like, some music playing over the recording. But, like, if you liked this, let me know. If you have specific things you'd like me to talk about with regards to my process, I could totally do that. But that will be all for now. Thank you guys again, and I hope to see you next time.